Hey YouTube, we're back this week, and in this video we do a complete overhaul of the fuel tank cover. It wasn't that hard to do it ourselves, and in this video we take you step by step and show you the whole process. We think you're gonna love this transformation, so watch to the end to see the amazing results. Today I'm going to be taking off the fuel tank cover. It's pretty soft in some areas. I have to repaint the tops on them too. Soft over here. The wood is probably rotted. So let's see what they look like. Now I'm gonna try to get this caulking off from the razor, if I could release caulking from the floor. A little trick to make this easier is you have the channel of caulk in the middle, so you want to try to go at an angles, one side this way, one side this way, try to release the caulk. It's rotted all right. You can see all this, it's just mush. I'm gonna have to replace all this. Here's the first cover I'm gonna go at. So I'm gonna come in all through here and all up in here. A couple tools I'm gonna use, the grinder. Pick this up for the sawzall attachment. Attachment for the grinder, respirator, some gloves, and you got some eyewear. This is coming out, it's ripped right up. So I picked up this Milwaukee. You can see a Milwaukee scraper blade for sawzall. I think it might be a little easier to use this, scrape all that crap off. So let's see. Wow. 10 out of 10 for this thing. Makes it so much easier, just goes right through it. The bigger pieces of wood, I might need to go back to the hammer or maybe a manual scraper, but. today I'm gonna do the backing for flooring fuel tank covers. And I picked up this 4 foot by 8 foot marine grade plywood, 3/4 inch. It's $98, so it's expensive. I made my circles. I'm gonna go ahead and use the jigsaw to cut these out. Get a nice clean cut. Check out my pallet hole. I'm gonna get some acetone, wipe down, and get ready for glassing. Lay out the chop strand mat. I'm gonna roll it back up and set it aside. It's ready to go.
I'm gonna mix the resin with the hardener. 64 ounces big. I'm gonna mix half of this. Roll this on. And whatever's left over, I'm gonna use for the peanut butter. I'm gonna add some cabasil or a filler so I can make the peanut butter. But I'm gonna do it inside because it's too windy. I'm gonna get it all over the place.
Not too bad. Come out and trim this after with your hardens. Looks pretty good. sanded it down. This, you can see the original color. It's like an off-white. I wanted to paint the whole floor white, so this is the first step. Took this hatch off, sanded it down, did a first coat with a roller with unwaxed gel coat. It was a disaster. I mean, I tried to get two coats on. It's just a mess. I did a lot of sanding to get it as even as I could. So I bought a spray gun. I'm gonna be spraying this from now on. I'm gonna do two more coats of unwaxed and then a final coat of waxed. And we bought some sand for the non-skid. Getting ready to shoot the fuel tank cover today. I have my unwaxed gel coat, my dump cup ready to go, my mixer for gel coat, MEK acetone, braider, my mask. Got this off Amazon, I think it was like $62. Came with the regulator. I have it running to a 60-gallon compressor with a chiller. So I'll be trying to shoot today. It's a little windy. I'll try to record as much as I can. I don't have much time to work with the gel coat because it's so hot out, it'll probably kick real quick. So I'm gonna try to shoot as quick as I can. So I'm gonna be, catalyzing at 1%. It's hot out, 1.5% it says here. So that's 4 cc's of MEK. And I'm gonna be using this filter for the mixed gel coat to catch any debris or any thick particles in there. So I'm gonna get clogged up in the gun. I'm gonna be shooting at 50 PSI. This lever's open about 3/4 of the way. And same with this one. And I'll go adjusting before I shoot. Get a good spray pattern. Let's get shooting. Off all the edges for the non-skid, which is next. I'm going with the razor now and my edges, the radius around that. We're gonna do one more non-wax coat. I have the non-skid particles I'm gonna add. Let that sit and then we'll top it with the wax to finish it off. So here we have nickel I used for the edges. Came out pretty good. I highly suggest you use an X-Acto knife. It's gonna come out the cleanest. We're ready for another spray and some sand. For the non-skid, I'm gonna go with the FGCI medium and soft grade. And I mixed them 50-50. And what I did was I got a soldering tool. I made some holes at the top to let a lot out. And so I can shake it as soon as I shoot the gel coat. I'm gonna shake it over the top, let it dry, let it cure. And then I'll brush off the excess. So I just laid down coat of unwaxed. So it's still wet. I'm gonna go ahead and shake on the non-skid. Now any excess after it cures, I can brush off and reuse. So I'm putting a real heavy coat. I just wanna make sure I get it. By the way, everything that I've learned has been from YouTube. I know nothing about this stuff. This is the first time ever doing this. I've never done this before. I'm learning as I go. Well, this has been blood, sweat, and tears. Literally, I mean, this boat has kicked my rear end time and time again, but a labor of love, right? Let's see. Not too bad. It came out pretty good. Now, top coat, and that's it. You know, if anybody's thinking about doing this themselves, go for it. I mean, I've never done this before, and just watched a lot of YouTube. With prices the way they are, you know, it's almost worth doing it yourself if you have the time. You know, I've been working on this project for a while now, and I really wanted to get this. This is really gratifying. Really happy with it.
you guys think in the comments, if you would have done things a little bit different, if you would have used paint versus Gelcoat. But if you like this video and it helped you out, like and subscribe. And if you want to see how we get this hatch done, tune in next week.